Hello everyone, this is Kingspade Designs. Today we'll be looking at how to design a simple, super cool 3D background, hexagonal background with Illustrator. Today I'll be going away from my normal CorelDRAW tutorials. From now I'll be mixing up with Photoshop tutorial, Illustrator tutorial, others. As I said earlier, this is what we are going to be doing today. How to design this background of this nature. Alright, without wasting of time, we are going to start right away. Okay, first of all, we are going to start with our background. We have to open a new file, go to new, then from here now we are going to insert our dimensions, our width. Let's say our width should be 2560 pixels and 1440 pixels, then okay. Here we go, this is our background. Now we are going to pick polygonal tool, just click on it, then insert. We are going to use a polygon of 128 as the radius, then 6 here, then click OK. Here is it, we now have our polygon. I'm going to zoom this out. Okay, now this is our polygon. What we are going to do now is to make this polygon. I need this pointed side to be at the top. What that's, I'm just going to hold down shift key, then rotate it to give me the top. From here now I'm going to copy this shape from edit, copy. Now I'm going to paste. Before I paste, notice from our layers we have, when I open up my layers, I have only just one part here. Okay, now I'm going to go paste in front. When I paste in front, you see it now gave me two layers. Okay, what I'm going to do to this now. Now, this second is the one that is highlighted. I'm just going to come to transform. I'm going to make this, let's say, it's 250, let's say 165. Sorry, forgot to do something. Whenever you are doing this, you are going to make sure this is on. When you click on this, that's the linking, make sure it is on. Then 165, enter. You now see it, the whole thing. I'm going to highlight both of them. From here, what I'm going to do now is to, I want to group them. Let me group them. Group. They are now has one file. But if you open their group, you see them single. Now what I'm going to do now is to add a guide to this. So I'm going to come to view, guide, then make this as guide. They will now look as guide. If you notice, the view now is just like me having empty lines guiding my work. So from here now, I'll just pick my pen tool. I'll pick pen tool, then on this I'm going to select, let me say red. Now I'll start. Remember, if you see very well, you must choose anchors. They should be on anchors. Then click on this anchor, on this other anchor, this other anchor. You are now seeing the effects. I started applying the shapes. Anchor, anchor, anchor. I'm done with that. You can see the part here. So I'm going to go to another anchor now. I'm going to do this anchor, 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 anchor. Now another anchor again. Anchor, 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 and close it up with this anchor. Now we have these three shapes together. So what I'm going to do now is to apply. I've seen these shapes, they are having something like black lines on them. I don't need all those black linings on this particular shape. I can just do that by selecting all of them, then come to this place, do no outline. You cannot see I have no outline on them. I can come, since I'm done with this, my guides, I'm done making use of these guides. I can easily, this is where the part that contains the guide. You can see, if you check here, you see it has labeled as guide. So I can just do away with this particular one. So the guides are no more there again. So I'll just, I can, okay. So I said earlier, now we'll add something like a gradient to this. I'm going to come to my gradient, double click on gradient. Now I'm going to select, possibly I'm going to like this part. I'll select a lighter shade of I think I'm okay with this. Then on this other part, I'm going to select also a lighter shade of it. Okay, I can use this to show the direction of how I want. I think I'm okay with this. Okay, what I'm going to do now straight away is to click on this second part now. Click on this, come to this place. It's going to copy the feel of this other, what I have in the initial work. It will copy the feel here. Okay, same thing with this other one. It's copying the same feel, but I don't want the same thing in this. I want to add a little difference in this one. So I'm going to make this redder. And the transparency of this, let me say I'm bringing it. I want the transparency to be, yeah. Okay, now I need this to have a very light shade on it. Okay, then on this other part, I need a very light. I think I'm okay. I think I'm done with this. You can edit all the shading any how you want it, anytime. But I think with this now, I'm okay with the way it looks like here now. So what I'm just going to do now, I can select all of them, then group them together. Now the next thing I'm going to do now is to apply, I need something like a shadow on this part. So I'm going to pick to return this back to back to black. Now I'm going to make use of my this in back to my ankles again. I'm going to make use of my ankles. Then let me say this way and close it up here. Do another one here. Say this way, close it up. Same. Okay, now what I'm going to do now is to select the three of them. I'll hold down shift key, click on the three shapes. You can see the three shapes now. What I'm going to do now, I'm going to group them together. When I group them together, you see how it looks like here. Just want to increase this a little so that you can see what I'm having here. Can do that. Others maybe make it, let me say 40 pixels. You can see how I increase this so that I'll see the whole layers very well. Now what I'm going to do now is to add my Gaussian blur to this. So I'm going to come to effect, you see blur, Gaussian blur. So I can just click on preview, see the preview of this. I think I need more, no, it's too much. I think, let me say 15 should. I think 15 is okay. 15 should be okay. Oh, let me add a little blur to it. Let's see, I'm making it 7, 18. Preview. Okay, I think I'm okay this way. So what I'm going to, from here now, I'm just going to select the whole work. Then, no, remember, I can't leave this thing just showing outside this way. What I'm going to do now is to click on this other group, the other group. Then what I will do is to copy. I have to create a max layer for this. Now select the shadows, that's the shadows I've created. When I select it, I will now come to appearance. So I mean transparency, I will come to transparency. Then on the max, I'm going to add, double click on it to add a max layer. Then what I'm going to do now is to paste in front. When I paste in front, you now see it has been able to max, we have maxed, so select the maxing that particular layer. Now select all and okay, sorry, I have to click on this to go back to the normal editing mode. Then highlight the whole, I can now group them together. So now from here now, I've gotten something interesting I can use. Okay, now what I'm going, next thing I'm going to do is to select both of them, select all, hold down my alternate key, then drag this to this point, release, drag this side to this point, release, drag again to this point, and release. Now this is not how we are going to leave our work. I don't need all this other part, I just need this center part in this work. So I'm just going to right click on this, I'll ungroup this work, ungroup. Now click on this, I'll delete, click on this, delete. Now this is the shadows, I'll delete it. Now same thing to this, I'm going to ungroup, ungroup, wait, so ungroup again. Now delete this, delete this part and also the shadow. Same thing with this other side, click on it, ungroup, right click, ungroup again, then click on this part, delete it. This other one, delete, and also the shadow, I'm going to delete it. Now we now have this super cool shape. Now what I'm going to do now is click on this part, same to hold shift key, click the second and click on this. Now what I'm going to do is to group the entire shape together. This is what we now have. So from here we're going to go straight into adding, we're going to create a smaller version of this whole entire pentagon. So I'm just going to create, click somewhere, then instead of 128, I'm going to, let's say I'm going to make this 100. Now I have a smaller version of this, my pentagon, but now I want it to be a solid color, so I need, let's say, white. I'm going to make it white. Now click. I have to rotate it to look like the other one. Now drag it down to this center. So the next thing I'm going to do now is to cut. I have to cut this out. Cut. When I cut, now come to this particular layer. This is the layer I'm working on now. This particular layer. I'm going to add a. Now paste in front. We've pasted it in front of this, but it's not really looking nice. I'm going to go back to this editing part. Now I don't need this to actually come out this way. I need it to be somehow at the back. So I'm just going to drag this whole shape down. This is our selection. Now you now see how our work pretty looks like. So from here now, what I'm going to do now is to come. We are going to add at least two effects to this. Now I'm going to select this. We are going to add something like an outer glue to this particular shape. So now, let me zoom it out so that we can see how everything is being. Okay, selecting this, I'll come to effect, then come to stylish, then outer glue. Let me say adding opacity 90%, opacity blur 5% should be okay. Preview. Okay, now see it added something like a blur to this particular shadow, to this particular side. So I'm going to add it again, because for we to get what we actually need. Yeah, when I show you, just click on yes. Okay, preview. Wow, super. This is actually what you can, for you to get this actual thick, bold outer glue in this. You have to do it, like 2 times for you to get it. Then from here, I'm just going to make it. Click on okay. All right, now from this part now, there's something I actually need to add to this. Let me see, I need to add something like, it's not looking, I think there's one or two effects on this. All right, we're going to now go into making, I'm going to add up from this part. I'm going to, making use of my normal pentagon, I'm going to now copy this pentagon again. We'll copy it again. Now we are going to paste it in front. Okay, we now have it pasted here, pasted in front. Now what we are going to do now in this whole pentagon sheet, I don't need this part, so I'm just going to come here and do away with this particular one. I'm going to click on hit and delete. That is gone on that particular shape. So what I'm going to do now, come to this place. I want to make it a solid color, so just hit black here. Now what I'm going to do now, I don't need this full. I'm going to come to transform. Remember the link is still highlighted. I'm going to make it, let's say, 215. Just need something like a smaller version of this particular shape. Now from here now, I'm going to add something like a Gaussian blur to it. Let me say come to Gaussian blur. Gosh, sorry, I hit on red eye. Gaussian blur. Let's see the preview. it a little. It's too much. Let me say 16. What about 20? Let me make it 30. Let me make this 30. So 30 should do. Okay. Alright. I'm okay with this. So what I'm going to do now, I'm going to come back to our effect, then come to artistic. When we come to artistic, we are going to film grain. Select film grain. Now I will select film grain. This is, let me bring out the shape so that you see how it looks like. Okay. This is it. I'm going to make a use of the grain should be 10, let's say 10, the grain should be 10, and let's say the intensity also should be 10. Then I'm going to just strike on OK. Wow, you now see how it looks like now. So as it is this way, we are going to now it's not actually looking, can't really leave it at the top that way. So what we are going sorry, now we are going just to sorry, I'm going to now, because it's not looking, this looks weird on this particular, on top of this, I'm just going to come now. Here is a layer of this, just going to drag it down to the lower part. Here's the layer. I'm going to drag it down to this lower. Now see, this is how it actually looks like. This is how our inner background actually looks like. Then I can just hit it maybe 1, 2, I think I'm okay, to the left. Then now, an effect we want to add to this now is to add something like this center image. We are going to do some a little editing on this. So what we are going to do now is select it, go copy it now, then we are going to paste it in front again. Trying to paste. Alright, we now have it pasted in front, but we are going to, so that we will be able to see what how our full editing, we are just going to drag it direct to the top most here. Okay, so now see it out of the listing. So what we are going to do now, we don't need all this, we have to get do away with all this outer glue we added here. So we are going to go to what we have, you see us, where we have our appearance. We go to appearance, then you see it, outer glue, you just click on it. You delete that, come to the second outer glue, you delete it. Now on that particular one, now we don't have outer glue on it, you can see it from your preview here. So what you are going to do now is you have to rotate this. So I'm going to right click, transform, come to rotate. 60 degrees is actually perfect for this, you can see the preview now. Okay, so now what I'm going to do is to drag it. I have to ensure it is aligned well at the center. Okay, now the next thing we are doing, I think it's looking too big. We are going to scale it a little, transform scale. Let's say I'm reducing the scale, uniform scale, reducing it to, let me say, 85%. Okay, it's a little bit smaller here now. No, let me, it's quite too big. too small. Let me say 93%. Okay, I think I'm okay with this. Okay, what I'm going to do to this now, we have it this way, but I need this thing to be inside, so I'm just going to right click on it, arrange, and we'll send it down to the back. Now we now have, can I see, as if this other shape trying to pull out from this particular center. I think I can, let me see if I can do some little editing on this. Let me stylish, artistic, film grain. Alright, you now see, you now have something like this other one trying to come out, pull out from this other shape. Okay, what I'm going to do from here now, just simply go, almost done with this. I'm going to add just a little effect on this. I'm going to go back to this particular shape, our original shape. Then, I'm not going to copy as usual. I'm going to copy this particular layer. Copy it, then again and paste it in front. Alright, that's pasted. So what I'm going to do right now is to go to Pathfinder. I'm going to go to Pathfinder, then confine our Pathfinder from our window button. Pathfinder, here is it. Let me just bring it here. So you see the unite shape here. I'm going to click on it. It's going to unite. Sorry, before I do that, I'm going to come to this. It's having, remember our shadow is there. I'm going to delete that shadow out. I don't need the shadow. So now on this, now I can now unite this shape now. When I unite it to now, it kind of try to blend the colors together. So now what I'm going to do now is click on my direct selection tool. When I click on direct, because I don't need this shape, center shape there again on this particular place. So I'm going to just click on this. It's going to select one node. So I'm just going to delete. When I delete the second time. We are now left with only this other shape. So what I'm going to do now on this shape, I just need it to be as one color, this thing background. So I'm just going to, let me say, return it to black. Then on my black, I'll ensure that the black, I give it a saturation, because I need something like a gray black. So I'm going to give it the brightness 50%, and here is it. This is what I got from this. So what I'm going to do from here now, I'm going to go to my green. I'll go to green, artistic, theme green. Now on this particular one, I just need the green to be something, let's say, make 5% green. Then intensity, I don't need any intensity on it. Let me see. Highlight, so I don't need the highlight. Then I'm just going to click OK. Wow, this is what we have now. But we can't really leave this work looking this way. We can't leave it this way. So what we are going to do, I'm going to go to appearance again. We'll go to appearance, then make it normal. I mean, soft light. Make it soft light. Oh, make it soft light. You see the way it's looking here. Now, the opacity, we are going to make the opacity 50% opacity. Now, you now see our work the way it's looking like now. We're done, actually done with the whole of this sheet. Now, what we are going to do now, since we want it to look like the usual, the other, this thing I showed you the other time, the whole shape, how everything comes up, we are going to just select everything here and group them together so that we can be able to do the necessary moving without distraction or interrupting. So now I'm going to go back to my normal. Let me view it normally. Quite big, let me reduce to 25 and see. Okay, let's see. I can work with this. So now let me just pick this. I can now let me reduce it a little. Okay. Now, I will just hold down my alternate key. I'm going to hold down. Let me zoom this part out so that we'll see. I'm going to hold down alternate key. Then I'll start laying this side by side. Be actually nice for me to keep on continue doing so. I can just select all of them, then drag it. Do the same thing. I'm going to do it a little bit so that it will go out of the particular shape. Now I'm going to select all of them and let's say drop it somewhere here. This way. Let me see. Okay, let me try and add one more to this side. So now I'm going to select the whole shape and do another duplication on it, but this time around it's going to be to lock it up a little. Yeah, I think I'm okay with this. Now, I can select the whole of them. Now, just select them. Let me make use of this other side. Same, hold on my alternate key. I'll drop. Hold on alternate again. Drop. We have like two more to do. Okay, for the sake of so that it can cover, I'm going to go one more step. Now, I'm going to do away with the last coach because it's coming too longer. I'm going to delete this last coach of it. Now, this is what we actually have, but I'm not going to leave this way because it will be looking like kind of weird. So we can't actually leave this way. We are going to create something like a mask. We are going to mask this particular layer. Trying to shift it to the left a little. Alright. Okay. What I'm going to do now is to we're going to now click on sorry. We're going to select our background. We're going to mask this into our background. Oh, first of all, let me highlight all of this shape. Select all, then we're going to group all of them together. Can always make reference to our layers. They are all now. You can see they are all together. Everything are now together in our max. Now what we are going to do now is to go to our polygon 2 again, rectangular 2, then click anywhere. Now recall our dimension for you use in this place. We use something like 2560 and 1440. That is what the dimension we use. Then I'm going to click on OK. See, it's going to create for me another, but I don't need it. I'm going to make use of maybe something whitish. Wait, I need white on it. So from here now, I'm going to now go to align, then make sure I'm aligning it to artboard, then click on this, I'm going to align it here, then to the left, so it has aligned it to the artboard for me. So what I'm going to do now is to click on copy. I'm going to cut this out now. Cutting it out, then click on this shape, come to my transparency, where I have my transparency, then add mask to it. Double click to add mask. Now come to edit, paste in front. Alright people, you can see we succeeded in creating that super cool 3D hexagonal looking 3D looking hexagonal background. You can now see. Okay, we're done with this particular tutorial. You can watch out for other of my tutorials that will be coming. Also, don't forget to subscribe to my channel, hit the subscribe button, and if you have any question, any difficulty somewhere, you can drop your questions and comments on the below the comment box below. All right, until next time. Don't forget to give this video a thumbs up. Alright, bye for now.